Welcome to Hard Hat Engineer. I am Varun Patel. In this video, you will learn about what is Code Standard and Specification. At the end of this video, you will also know the difference between them. Please subscribe to my channel to get regular updates on new video because it helps me to increase my reach on YouTube. So please subscribe. Let's start with standard. Standard can be defined as a set of technical definitions and guidelines, or simply a how-to instruction for designer and manufacturer. It gives all the necessary requirements for the product, service, and operation. A designer will use the standard to design the product, and a manufacturer will use the standard for the manufacturing of the product. Standards serve as a common language for defining quality and establishing safety criteria for the product. ASTM, API, ISO are some of the examples of the standards. ASTM has more than 12,000 standards. They cover almost everything. If you visit ASTM website, they say they have a standard for toy to aircraft. Why this standard required? Let's take an example of mobile phone charger. If you are in the US and traveling to India, you need an adapter to use the power charger, as both the country follows the different standard for power sockets. But your USB cable will work anywhere in the world because it is manufactured as per globally accepted standard. In the case of process industry, piping components are sourced from around the world. We want all this material, irrespective of their country of origin, should fit perfectly with each other at the site. Standard helps to achieve this by establishing common engineering or technical requirements for product, practice, method, or operation that manufacturer has to follow while manufacturing piping components. Some other benefits are also there, such as standard build confidence about product quality in the user, and with standardization, cost of production will reduce as you can produce in the bulk for the global market. Let's learn about code. When governmental bodies adopt the standard and become legally enforceable, or when standard has been incorporated into business contract, the standard will become a code. ASME codes are legally enforceable in many US states, whereas in the other part of the world, they are not legally enforceable, but such countries have their own similar codes. Please note that the requirement mentioned in the code will only be mandatory requirements if the code is adopted as a law by the regulatory body or it is part of the business contract. Otherwise, code will serve as a generally accepted guidelines for design, fabrication, construction, and installation. However, almost all process facility follows various American code and standard in addition to their national standard. Example of the codes are ASME boiler and pressure vessel code, British standard, German standard, etc. Why code required? Code provides a set of rules that specify the minimum acceptable level of safety and quality for manufactured, fabricated, or constructed good. Codes also refer out to the standard or specification for the specific detail on additional requirements that are not specified in code itself. The last one is specification. Specification provides specific additional requirements for the material, components, or services that are beyond the code or standard requirements. For example, if you want A106 grade B pipe with maximum carbon of 0.23% against standard requirement of 0.3% max carbon, you have to specify your requirement in your specification or in purchase order when you place the order to manufacturer. Specifications are generated by private companies to address additional requirements applicable to specific product or services. Why specification required? It allows purchaser to include special requirements as per the design and service conditions. It allows customizing your product. Please note the requirement in specification are must meet requirements. Example of specifications are product specification, shell DEP, EIL specification, etc. Here in this table, I have summarized what I have explained to you. You can hold the video and review the table for the better understanding. Or you can visit my website hardhatengineer.com to check the script of this video. Hope you have learned from this video. Please subscribe to my channel to get regular updates on new video and also like and share my video with your friends. If you want to request a video on the specific topic that you want to know more, please write in the comment. And don't forget to check free piping component guides by visiting my website hardhatengineer.com. See you soon. Goodbye. Take care.